Hey everybody, this is Singing Diva and you're listening to Dina Red and the Shiznit Show.
You are listening to the Red Rock Podcast Network, featuring Pod of Thrones and
the Shiznit.
This is the Red Rock Podcast Network. From Red Rock Studios in Los Angeles, California, this is the Shiznit. Now, put your hands together for the Shiznit.
Welcome to another episode of the Shiznit Show. I am your boy. I am your host, Dino Red. And I have with me, as always, my ride or dies. Well, Miss Deja Monique is on vacation, turning up for her birthday.
Turn up for what?
But the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Pip Lilly.
I'm showing up here, man. I'm so excited to be here today. What a week.
Me too. I had a good week. You know, I have to admit, I get a little excited when we are having a show without Dejan.
Oh, don't say that on that mic.
Well, not because I don't think the show is better without her, because it's not.
It's definitely not.
It's not. But only, you know what? Let me rephrase. It's not even when we have a show with her. I'm a little excited whenever we're together in the same place without Dejan, just because I know it's, no matter what she's doing, no matter how much fun she's having, it drives her a little bit crazy because she thinks she's missing out, or she don't want to miss out.
Oh, yeah.
And she's like that time she came in and burst in with a surprise. She was so proud of herself.
I'm expecting her to come down the stairs today. I'm really holding out because it's like, it could happen.
It could.
Yeah, she got that with FOMO, fear of missing out.
Yes, she has that with us.
Yeah, straight
up. She don't want us. She don't want to miss out nothing.
When we downtown, I mean, we like literally blocks from each other.
Right.
And she way in another part of the city.
Yes.
And she not there. And she like, oh, I want to be there.
Right. It don't matter if we having McDonald's or having lunch at the Four Seasons. She wants to be involved.
I owe her though. I have iced on her twice in a week's time.
Oh.
Yeah. The first time maybe could have been avoided. The second time could not. Like the first time was her birthday. I just had to work late, and I was like, I'm not gonna make it in time. So, and then I already had plans with Jason.
Mm-hmm.
And then she and I are supposed to go out for drinks on this past Thursday to celebrate. And then on Thursday morning at 4:30 a.m. Jason calls me. I can't see very well. My eyes are burning. Even the light from the phone is burning my eyes. So I'm like, all right, let me get into shower, get dressed, get over there. I get over to his house about 5:30. I got coffee in hand, breakfast sandwiches. We need to go to urgent care. He got some sort of eye infection, probably.
Wow.
Yeah. So we go to this urgent care downtown, 24 hours, like, and they're like, oh, we wait. And then they say, oh, yeah, we only take workers' comps. So they're like, well, where else can we go?
Right.
Well, there might be this other place over here. There might be them. I'm like, oh, okay, might be, ain't good enough. So we went to an urgent care place near my old house by USC. And then, you know, it's county. So we wait. He sees a doctor, and we wait. And then he goes to get some blood work, and we wait. Then he goes to see the ophthalmologist on the same campus, and we wait. Now it's noon. So then the ophthalmologist says, you need to go to the hospital. I know a doctor at USC LAC Medical, and he'll take it real good care of you. So they're like, you might have to go to the ER to get in. So I'm like, oh, man, this is exactly what happened to me. We're actually at the facility where I was before I went to the hospital, and then I went to county. But I went in an ambulance. I'm driving Jason around.
Mm-hmm.
So we get to county. We don't have to go to ER. We go to ophthalmology. Room packed, wall-to-wall sick people, wall-to-wall.
Now, see, that's weird. You don't usually expect the specialists to be packed like that. You expect urgent care,
right.
The ER.
Right.
you know, your general doctor, but not like an ophthalmologist.
Well, you go in there in that unit, and it's a sign on the wall, waiting hour, 2 to 5 hour wait with appointment.
Wow.
No walk-ins.
Wow. That dude is popular.
Well, it's more than one doctor in that unit.
Okay.
But it's still crazy.
Dang, a lot of people got eye problems.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I don't know. Stuff flying off the streets, hitting people in the face. And I don't know what's going on, but people can't see in L.A.
Wow.
And we don't wait.
That explains the traffic.
Yeah. People can't see.
Yeah. I wonder why traffic's so bad.
Oh, my God. So we waiting some more there. We don't wait 2 to 5 hours. We wait maybe an hour and a half because this other doctor had called ahead, told of the circumstance that we had been waiting so long at this other clinic.
Okay.
And so he saw us, but we it still took the procedures and stuff took a while because I got to dilate your eyes and wait for that.
Yeah.
And they wasn't dilated enough, so I had to do the drops again.
Right.
So it was a long, long day. So by the time it got to, like, maybe a couple hours before Dijon and I was supposed to meet, I'm like, girl, no. I've been up all day. I hadn't eaten.
Yeah, that's understandable.
Yeah.
That's understandable. That was a very taxing.
Oh, my God.
You went through it.
Oh, we sure did. And then we were, now we're back at his place. He still can't see. Actually, we went to Rite Aid to get his medication. He don't have insurance. $350 for some eye drops, $150 for the antibiotics.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. So we get back to his place. It's 5 o'clock. We still haven't eaten since the breakfast and coffee that morning. So now it's rush hour, right? So we're going to order delivery, hour and a half delivery.
Oof.
So we don't eat for 13 hours or something like that. And then we
eat. Y'all probably was snapping at each other and everything.
Oh, my. There was one person snapping.
It was Pip.
And his name is Pip.
Right.
Dude, okay, this is the best part. So I'm loving, I think. I got up at 4:30 in the morning to go take care of old boy,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So I drove him around. You know, I took the whole day off from work.
Right.
We get to the ophthalmology place. I'm exhausted by this time, right?
Mm-hmm.
And my phone is going dead, so I got to charge it. So I get up as a charger, a plug literally 10 feet from me.
Mm-hmm.
So I get up and I plug up my phone. And then I turn around, and there's somebody sitting in my seat next to Jason.
Wow.
It's an older Latino woman, and I'm like, oh, my God, I'm so disgusted. Disgust on my face, and I'm thinking, do I now go up and say this is my seat and try to make her get up?
Yeah.
I'm in a room full of Hispanics, and she clearly, like, probably in her 60s, you know, and I'm mm-hmm. like, no, they're going to think I'm beating up on her. I would look younger than my age, too. I got dreads, right? They're not going to be like, you know, they're not thinking, oh, he's 50.
You know
he's
who he looked like today?
Who?
Foo Snickens. Remember them?
No.
Oh, it's the hip-hop group. They were, like, from the islands.
Okay.
And they had this accent, whatever, and they're really good. They were kind of underrated. They didn't get a very big, like... You know, they weren't crossover.
Right.
But they're very talented. And it was like three island dudes. And they're like brown-skinned dudes. And they would have the dreads and they have them.
All
like
twisted it, up.
Like, just like you have them right now. You look like a Foo Snicking.
Oh, cool. I'll take that.
Pip-Foo.
I'll take that.
Yeah,
I'll
Pip-Foo.
Take that.
That's
who
you look
like.
That. Pip-Foo. That's your Foo Snick's name.
Dude, I'm styling today. I'm straight up styling today.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
That's all good. I didn't kick the lady out of her seat, but I was so mad at Jason, man. And then he said, well, I didn't know what to do. Like, she sat in this. I was like, dude, I got up at 4:30.
He was supposed to say, excuse me, the seat's taken.
Exactly.
That's all you had to say. I'm with somebody. They're sitting here. You know, the seat's taken.
I was so mad.
That was whack.
Like,
that was whack on his part.
I was like, I know you're sick. But
yeah.
I took off from work, dude.
He get an L for that.
He did apologize. He got it.
Okay.
He got it. So let
me ask. What were you and Dijon supposed to do that you weren't able to do because of all
this?
We
were going to go to a bar in our neighborhood.
Okay.
And during happy hour, and on Thursday nights during happy hour, they show the East Coast feed of RuPaul's Drag Race.
Ah. Okay.
So we was going to watch that and have some drinks. Okay. I was going to have two drinks.
Mm-hmm.
And then watch Dijon.
Have the rest.
I got to be careful with her. She think I'm her age. And it's happy hour, too, so drinks is cheap.
Yeah.
$5 wells,
right.
Like $3 beers.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's,
no.
Oh, boy.
So this it's been that kind of week.
Okay.
So I'm glad to be here.
Yeah, me too. And do you know what today is?
What is today, Dino?
Not mine and yours. Me and my wife's.
Oh, that's right.
It's
I knew
my
that.
Anniversary, yeah.
It's on, so many days, so many things connected to this day.
I know, along with St. Patrick's Day.
I don't celebrate that.
Yeah, well, I mean, I kind of do and kind of don't. I don't go out and drink green beer or anything, but we generally have corned beef and cabbage.
I love corned beef and cabbage.
Which I'm making for dinner today.
Well, I buy my corned beef on March 18th.
Okay.
That's a pit. I should say that for a broke-ass hack. Because every year they go on sale the day after.
Yeah, well, they actually be on sale before. Yeah. So they probably go on a deeper sale afterwards because of all the, they have like such a large stock left over. Yeah.
Now they got to move on to their hams.
Yeah. Easter.
That's right. Yeah.
But it's the anniversary. 14 years today.
Congratulations.
We've been married 14 years, together 15. Yeah, they said it wouldn't last. Had to prove them wrong.
Shout out to my friend Scott Ferguson. It's his 51st birthday today. Shout out to my friend Jenna Frey.
Wow.
It's her birthday. I won't say the number today.
All right.
But she's below 50. I'll give her that.
I hear you. So, I don't know. I've been feeling better. You know, I've been back to work. I just finished my second week back after being off for like 6 weeks. And, man, it was a much needed break. You know, I got to reset my system and everything.
Yeah.
And, you know, I've been, you know, seeing my therapist and all that, and I'm feeling a lot better. The same bullshit is there at work still, but it's just not. It's not having the same effect on me that it was before because I've had this break. You know, I've been able to like. I was telling my one therapist, I felt like I'm ready to go to war. You know what I mean? I felt strong. I felt ready, like mentally prepared and just better, you know?
I know you're feeling good because you've been posting on social media.
Did I stop?
You was just a little more...
Like, just kind of like posting
like
the show.
Work show stuff and things like that. But like you posting like family pics and stuff like that. Oh, he's out and about. They doing stuff.
Yeah. So I'm feeling better. So mental health, people, not a joke. It's real. It's real.
And it affects a lot of
it
people.
It does. And I can't advocate for counseling enough. I mean, it's helped me through quite a few. It's helped me in my marriage.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it took us from, you know, when we first started going to counseling, we both felt like the shit was going to blow up any day now.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And we went from that. It was a road. It didn't happen overnight.
Right.
And it's still work. It's still hard.
Right.
But now it's like it's, you know, it's as good as it's ever been, you know, better than it's ever been. So
it seems most people go into counseling or therapy when they're in crisis.
Yeah.
And that's just because the way we've been taught in our society, because you would think, you know, we try to do preventative care for everything else except our minds.
That's true.
And it's kind of crazy that way, because I've learned personally that whenever I have any kind of major change, that I should seek counseling just as a check-in. You know, like if I change jobs or I move, something like that, because all that stuff affects you.
Yes, the change is highly stressful.
Yeah.
And it's very stressful.
I'm in a new relationship right now. I actually should be in counseling.
Right.
No, I'm serious.
I know what you're saying.
Not because anything's wrong,
right.
Just a check-in I don't start acting out in the relationship.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, that's very smart. But yeah, we don't always do that for numerous reasons, but... Like they say, better late than never. But
exactly.
I definitely encourage people to, you know, if you don't, fuck the stigmas. You know what I'm saying? Just get over that, especially, I want to say especially Black people, because that's what I am and that's what I know. I don't know about other cultures, but I know our culture has a stigma.
Definitely.
You know, I've heard it many times. You know,
you just need Jesus.
Or that's one. Another one. Oh, that's for white people.
Oh, no, it's not.
Counseling or going to psychiatrists. That's for white people. We don't do that. Black people don't do that. You know, we don't, but we should.
We should.
It's not just for white people.
We should. And if you think about it again, if you go on in crisis, that's like waiting till, you know, the boil on your skin is the size of a grapefruit to go get it fixed.
Yeah.
Right? And like I said, it's going to take a while to heal.
Right.
Because you waited so long.
Yeah.
So go take care of your business, folks.
It helps.
Plus, really on does. Top of that, all your friends and family be making you mad when you be telling them stuff. When you go to counseling, you ain't got nobody to be mad at but yourself.
Right.
Because they just sort of working with you to make you feel better about your life.
Yep. All right, we ready to get in those topics?
I'm so ready.
Let's go.
News and noteworthy.
The Shiznit.
So up first we have...